while they know you, to pray to God clearly, and only experience the peace of the super small universe, which meant the best. He experiences like Moses and Elijah, on their respective mountaintops, are beyond mountains. It's almost a hard job to God sent Christ into the world to redeem the world and show us how to repent of our sins. Sometimes we look at Scripture and wonder what makes it. We have no personal reference to what happened on that holy mountain, no process of understanding. So we need to look at Scripture not in isolation, but rather as part of the greater thing. So he tells them that for 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, and led them to a mountain by themselves. The reference to 6 days later tells us the Lord had lived on the larger mountain. 6 days previously, Jesus asked his disciples about the Son of Man. But what about you? Who do you say that I am? Simon Peter answered, you are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God. Here we have the very first public declaration of faith in Jesus and his ministry. Peter recognized who Jesus is. It is only a partial recognition. His power, they want him to come into his glory, but they do not understand all that he does. What they wanted was Jesus to use his power to remove their oppressors and to usher in the new kingdom of God. But Jesus began to explain to his disciples what must happen. That he must go to Jerusalem, that he must suffer at the hands of the elders, and the teachers of the law, that he must be killed, but on the third day raised to life. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. Never, Lord, he said, this shall never happen to you. And Jesus turned the corner and said, get behind me, Satan. I think transformative power of Jesus. We want the glory to shine from our lives. But we do not want to put in the work that is necessary to be transformed. Peter saw the Messiah, but not the sacrifice. He was unable to comprehend what Jesus told him. Peter recognized Jesus as Messiah. Saw divine power in him and within him. He rejects Jesus and asks him of his suffering and sickness. Simply unable to believe that something like this is possible. And despite rebuking him, Jesus knows his potential and takes the 3 disciples with him to bear witness to God's transformative power. The divine presence of God, the Holy, putting aside the mundane. This is God coming into the world and making things happen. God placed Jesus in that moment, revealing Jesus' true self, a vision of the body of the experience. And with Christ, we're called to share the gospel with the world around us. We may not have mystical experiences on land breaks. We may not hear God's voice during the cloud of the cloud. Nevertheless, we have the message that God forgot to love the Son. This is faith to go out into the world and proclaim the risen